In the scientific and clinical world, we understand very well that Marburg is as dangerous as is other viral hemorrhagic fevers. We have had several outbreaks in this country. We know that these commonly occur in Africa, and in Uganda we've had so far 4 Marburg outbreaks, and each of them has had fatal consequences.
Here in Uganda, there are some drugs whereby we are lacking. So from that, I decided, let me be part of it. You never know, maybe in the future, this vaccine, it can be part of one of the drugs which we do have in Uganda.
Sudan Ebola and Marburg, right now there are no vaccines. There are no treatments. And so Sabin is getting after that. We're developing the vaccines. So this is a phase 2 clinical study where we're testing the Marburg vaccine. It's going to be tested in East Africa across 2 different sites. One site's going to be in Uganda, Kampala, and the other one's in Kenya, Siaya. So this could be the first vaccine for Marburg, and we're excited about that.
So Marburg, like Ebola, is a viral hemorrhagic fever that is really nasty, has a high fatality rate. So by producing and testing these vaccines, both in Africa as well as the US, we are creating opportunities to be able to protect ourselves and the global community against these diseases moving forward.
It is important for scientists like us, or researchers like us, to engage the community way, way early as we develop the products.
I first heard it from a friend. Yeah, then from my friend, then the doctors and the nurses, they made a reach out. They taught us about how the Marburg virus is.
You have to get their approval. And so we went there to the local government offices. It's important that we got there and said, this is our mission. We want to mitigate the suffering and death associated with these viral diseases. We're doing this to be ready for the next outbreak.
If the research does not happen here, it is going to take us longer to deal with hesitancy. But it will also take us longer to have access to these products as countries that are not able to do the production ourselves. So if we're not producing the products, the vaccines or medicines, whatever, at least let us participate in the development.
Both of these sites are really well established, have done multiple phase 1 and phase 2 trials, and have been part of large pharma studies and really complex trials as well, both for HIV, Ebola, TB, COVID.
The epidemics are happening here in Africa more than they are happening in the global, the rest of the world. So who's best placed to test these products other than those of us who actually get the outbreaks? We do have the cases, we do have the scientists, we do have the populations that are fairly well sensitized to participate if you do the right thing. I think it is important for these trials to happen here.
We are so appreciative. If possibly, let them bring it more and more for us in the future.